Good day, everyone. Today, I will discuss the language of computers. This is very important for you, computer engineering students, to understand language of computers, so that later on, if we go into programming, we can also understand how our program works. Anyways, before we go to C++ programming, we will first discuss how does computers communicate. Looking at us people, we can work together if we have a good communication. Same as well with our computers. They also communicate to produce our expected output. Have you noticed? If you press A in your keyboard, lalabas sa screen or monitor is A. Kung B naman ang ipipress mo, B yung lalabas sa monitor. Malamang. But have you actually think of it? Bakit kaya? Why? Have you wondered, ano kaya ang nasa keyboard na yan? Well, that's how computer works. As we all know, computer is an electronic device. When you say electronic, this means that electrical signals are flowing inside our computers to process information. Actually, there are two types of electrical signals. First, we have analog signal. Analog signals are continuously varying waveforms used to represent such things as sound. Diba? When we talk, pwedeng malakas, mahina, malumanay, etc. We cannot define specific value of our voice. Okay? Because it is in waveform. And we have digital signals. Digital signals represent information through zeros and ones, high or low, on or off. Pag mataas or high yung voltage na dumadaan sa wire na yon, 1. Pero pag mababa naman, yung dumadaan na voltage doon, 0. So, when you say digital signal, we can determine kung what time siya 1 at kung what time siya 0. Let us take for example, look at your bulb na nasa bahay. As you can observe sa switch, merong 1 at 0, or just an indicator of 1 or 0. If you press 1, iilaw ang bulb. If you press 0, then it will be turned off. That is how computers communicate, by using series of zeros and ones. Since digital signals are being processed in computers, we call this language as machine language. Machine language is actually a series of zeros and ones. So each digit in the machine language is called a binary digit, or in short, bit. Sometimes, this series of bits is also called binary code or binary number. Bakit kaya binary? It is actually from the prefix bi, which means two. Diba? We have 0 and 1. We can only see zeros and ones in the binary number. So let us take note, bit is a binary digit that can be either 0 or 1. Now, if 8 bits ng sequence, we call it a byte. Then, 2 raised to 10 bytes, which is equal to 1024 bytes, is actually 1 KB or 1 kilobytes. Now, as you can see, in our table, these are the binary units that is being used in the computers or in the computer industry. So, this is actually used sometimes in our storage capacity or memory capacity. So, we have there byte, kilobyte, megabyte, gigabyte, terabyte, petabyte, exabyte, and zettabyte. So, to answer the question kanina about if A ang pinindot mo sa keyboard ay A din ang lumalabas sa screen, it is because every letter, number, or special symbol in your keyboard is encoded as a sequence of bits, each having a unique representation. So that means si A ay may sariling sequence compared to B, compared to C, or to any other characters on your keyboard. The most commonly used encoding scheme on personal computers is the 7-bit American Standard Code for Information Interchange, or commonly known as ASCII. If you will look at ASCII dataset, each letters, numbers, and symbol has its own 7-bit representation. For example, letter A, or capital letter A, is represented as 1000001. Since computer processes 8 bits or by byte, we will be converting the ASCII representation by adding 0 to the left. So the final representation of the capital letter A will become 01000001. So that's it. That is how computers communicate. I hope you have learned a lot from this video tutorial. Thank you and God bless. Padayon Engineering.